السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
Today I'm going to talk about
amazing character. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named himself with that character. And that character is so important to apply in our life.
What this is character? What kind of character? Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of his character, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most merciful. La ilaha illallah. Ar-Rahim, Ar-Rahim, the merciful. And from that Ar-Rahim, from this word, a lot of names comes from. Like Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, or Ar-Rahma, the mercy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order us to have this character, the mercy. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, unlimited. Unlimited. No one can describe it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this sifa, this character, it's mentioned in Al-Holy Quran, and all the roots from that word, Ar-Rahim, Ar-Rahim or Ar-Rahma, it's mentioned and multiplied in the Holy Quran many places, 315 times. This sifa, and the root of that sifa, the root of this description, it's repeatedly mentioned the Holy Quran 315 times. Other sifa, as-sidq, honest, to be an honest, is 115 times, 145 times, and as-sabr, patience, 90 times, and the afu, forgiveness, 43 times, and the to be a generous, al-karam, it's mentioned 42 times, and al-amana, to be worthy, to be trusted, 40 times, wasifat al-wafa, to pay back the promise, and be good in return, it's a mention 29 marra, 29 times. And all this sifat, it's repeatedly mentioned the Holy Quran, but you realize that sifat al-rahmah, the mercy, is the highest number mentioned compared to the one I mentioned to you. 315 times. Why is repeatedly mentioned the Holy Quran? As a wake-up call for all human beings and all the creation, that sifa, this character, is very important to put it in our life. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about his sifa, his character in the Holy Quran. Allah says in Surah Al-A'raf 156, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. And my mercy fits everything, wider than anything. All this creation, that my mercy can fit all of them, all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. My mercy so wide, so that can fit everything. Allahu Akbar. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه in the hadith قال إن الله لما قضى الخلق, when Allah created the creation, كتب عنده فوق العرش, Allah wrote something in the arsh, in the throne of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a statement, golden statement, Allah wrote it. From that time, after Allah created the creation, Allah write, Allah ordered to be written, إِنَّ رَحْمَتِي سَبَقَتْ غَضَبِي. My mercy faster than my anger. My mercy reach faster than all my anger. That the mercy of Allah faster and wider. لا إله إلا الله. And this is the narration of Imam al-Bukhari. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says, جعل الله الرحمة 100 جزء. Allah made the mercy 100 parts. فأمسك عنده 99 جزءا وأنزل في الأرض جزءا واحد فمن ذلك الجزء يتراحم الخلق حتى ترفع الفرس حافرها عن ولدها خشية أن تصيبه. In this hadith that Prophet Muhammad says, indeed Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made 100 mercy, and he kept for himself 99 mercy for the day of judgment. And Allah sent over this earth
only one part, one mercy from the 100 part of mercy. جزء واحد. And from that mercy in the earth, the creation have mercy over each other. Even the animals, even the mother of the horse lift her leg up to make sure that she will not step over her child or baby. Allahu Akbar. All this is a part of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 99 mercy Allah kept it for the day of the judgment. And when mercy Allah sent it down, and whatever mercy we see in front of our eyes between a human being, between animals, any kind of mercy we see, this is just one of that part when Allah sent it down in the earth. Allahu Akbar. Another hadith. قال قدم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بسبي فإذا امرأة من السبي تبتغي إذا وجدت صبيا في السبي أخذته فألصقته ببطنها وأرضعته. فقال لنا صلى الله عليه وسلم. In this hadith, Umar bin Khattab, he says, when the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم come, he says, قدم على الرسول, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, السبي, a slave woman came to the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. إذا وجدت صبيا في السبي. Then suddenly, when she arrived, she saw among of the people a young boy. And when she see that young boy, she understand that her child, she lost him. That her child. So she ran towards him, and she hugged him, and she gave him milk, and she put him so close to her chest. And out of mercy, she was frustrating for long looking for her child, and she found him, and she put him closely to her chest, and she gave him breastfeeding. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Sahaba amazed, watching, Allah, what kind of love? They saw this woman, how she ran towards her baby. Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned, do you have thought that this mother has any ability to throw her baby or child in hellfire or in fire? They said it's impossible. Look at the love, look at the attachment, look at the connection, look at the mercy from that mother towards her baby. Then he said to them, قُلْنَا لَا وَاللَّهِ, it's impossible that she will throw her child in fire. وَاللَّهِ وَهِيَ تَقْدِرُ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَطْرَحَهُ. فَقَالَ صلى الله عليه وسلم, لَاللَّهُ أَرْحَمُ بِعِبَادِهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ بِوَلَدِهَا. مُتَّفَقٌ عَلَيْهِ. That Allah has more mercy than this woman towards her baby. So Allah, so merciful to His creation, to the human being, to the jinn, to all His creation, more than this mother towards her baby. Allahu Akbar. What a great mercy from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, alhamdulillah, that our Creator so merciful. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the mercy inside our heart and let us learn and become a merciful person. My beloved brothers and sisters, another hadith. This is all a hadith, authentic, for us to learn and implement it and analyze it and feel it and feel the connection towards the Creator, because Allah has so much mercy. And this character, amazing character. Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu said that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the hadith, لَنْ يَدْخُلَ أَحَدٌ مِنْكُمْ عَمَلَهُ الْجَنَّةِ. No one enter the Jannah with his deeds. So your deeds is not enough or give you enough capacity or capable that you are eligible to enter Jannah. All our good deeds is not enough. For example, if someone offer you a house cost $1 billion and you only have $100 and you give them $100 to buy the house. $100, nothing. He said, go. This is not even a price for the tree outside of the house. The house worth $1 billion, and you only want to pay $100. So our all good deeds in this dunya is not enough payment for the paradise, the one Allah created and prepared for all the mankind forever. It's not enough. But the mercy of Allah is the reason for us to enter Jannah. Without mercy of Allah, no one enter Jannah. And this is the meaning of the hadith. No one entered Jannah with his because of his good deeds. قال ولا أنت يا رسول الله. How about يا رسول الله? You always do عبادة and salah and prayer. Even you يا رسول الله. He said يا رسول الله. قال ولا أنا. Even me. إلا أن يتغمدني الله بفضله بفضل ورحمة. متفق عليه. رواه الإمام البخاري. That even me, our deeds not enough. That we are eligible to enter Jannah unless if Allah give us mercy. So the mercy of Allah is the main reason for us to enter Jannah. Without mercy of Allah, we are not really eligible to enter Jannah. لا إله إلا الله. أن رحمة من صفات أهل الجنة. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم about the characteristic of the people of paradise. What their character? Look at their character. Please remember this hadith. Three characters of the people of paradise. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم أهل الجنة ثلاثة. The people of paradise, there are three categories. ذو سلطان المقصد. A person who is a leader or king or in charge, but he is a justice. Second one, متصدق موفق. A person, he gives charity and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help him to do charities for all good, for all aspects. ورجل رحيم. And a person has a mercy. One of the people of Jannah characteristic, a person who has mercy, his heart merciful. رقيق القلب, soft heart. لكل ذي قربى ومسلم. And he is helpful for all the relatives and all Muslims and all believers. And the last one, وَعَفِيفٌ مُتَعَفِّفٌ ذُو عِيَالٍ. A person, he has family and children, and he seek the rizq of halal. Seek rizq for halal to help his family and help his children. Those is the characteristic of the people of Jannah. Find yourself. You are one of these four, the one I mentioned. The easiest one, رجل رحيم. Easiest in talk, but in the action, need effort. If you are tough and harsh, and always choose the hard part, or always judge people in negative way, or punishing, or harsh, or scolding, remember, the person who has mercy in his heart, and he's helpful to everyone, this is the characteristic of the people of Jannah. So be among of the character of the people of Jannah. Be among those people who has these characters, my beloved brothers and sisters. Don't ignore it or deny it. وَقَدْ تَوَعَّدَ الرَّسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْحَمُونَ. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم warn, give warning. Warning over those, the one that doesn't have a mercy over the people. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, one of the smallest hadith and shortest hadith, and I'm sure all of you can now memorize it. Very easy, but very important to implement it. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا يرحم الله من لا يرحم الناس. Allah will not have mercy over a person who does not have mercy over people. Allah will not have mercy over a person who does not have a mercy over others. As you do, as you receive. This is the hadith. لا يرحم الله من لا يرحم الناس. لا يرحم الله من لا يرحم الناس. Allah will not have mercy over a person. He doesn't have a mercy over people. Hadith متفق عليه. Narrator, Imam Bukhari, Muslim. Allahu Akbar. How many of us now, we are so hard at work over, if he make mistake, we pay him. Or we are harsh on other people. He has to do, I already pay, and I'm tough, and treat people with materialistic or only with the value of money. And the mercy taken away from our hearts. Harsh person, punish, use the tough word, curse. Or wherever you try to please him, never be pleased. Where is the mercy, my beloved brothers and sisters? At work, with your family, with your children, with your community, with your relative, with your parents, if the parents still alive, may Allah have mercy over all our parents, the one who pass away or the one who is still alive. Mercy is very important, my beloved brothers and sisters. قالت رسول الله عليه وسلم. Allah says in the Holy Quran about Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at this verse. Look at this verse. Surah Al-Anbiya, verse number 107. What Allah says about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have sent you, O Muhammad, as a merciful, merciful to all mankind, to all the creation, not only human being, not only the jinn kind, even the animals and trees and everything. صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا أيها الناس إنما أنا رحمة مهدا. He said, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, indeed, O people, I am a merciful. Allah guided me. I am a merciful. Allah guided me. My beloved brothers and sisters, if you would like to become a winner over the mercy of Allah, if you are would like to be a winner over the mercy of Allah, that Allah will have mercy on you, first of all, remember that the mercy of Allah feeds everything, wider than anything, unlimited. Allah have ability to have mercy over whomever He will. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one stop Almighty Allah. Don't think that person, he wal'iyadu billah, drinking alcohol. This person, Allah will not forgive him. Allah will not have mercy on him. Who you are to say this? Maybe Allah will have mercy on that person and guide him, and Allah will destroy all your good deeds. Who you are to judge this person, or say about this person, or talk about this person, as you are, mashallah, you Jannah, the key of Jannah in your pocket, and you're going to open the Jannah. Who you are, even you have long beards, or you memorize the Quran, no one will enter Jannah with his deeds or his knowledge, except with the mercy of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to understand the limitation and where we stand for. Very important advice. Some Muslims, they feel they are the best and the others is rubbish. And this is really disgusting and arrogant. The person removed the mercy from his heart, he might be, wal'iyadu billah, destroying himself. So first of all, as I mentioned to you, how to win the mercy of Allah, be muhsin. What is the meaning muhsin? Al-ihsan. Al-ihsan, wide word, cover many aspects of life. So it's an asl, it's an original word of al-ihsan. Do better, do better, do better. In what? In mu'amalat, how to deal with others. Be better, be better, be better. In what? In akhlaq and manners. Inna rahmatullah. Rahmatullah what? Qareeb. Near to whom? Min al-muhsin. From the one who doing the best, the better. Ihsan. The mercy of Allah so close to them. Farahmatullah qareebun min al-muhsinin. Those the one they worship Allah as they see Allah in front of them. And if they not able to worship Allah with that status, they remember that Allah watch over them all the time. That's how the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ihsan, my beloved brothers, be muhsin. Worship Allah as you can see Him. So in order to get the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, very important. After to have ihsan inside your heart and in your action, very important to win the mercy of Allah that you have iman, faith and belief, and taqwa, which is awareness of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-A'raf 156 and 157, Allah says, look at this ayah, this is enough. A reminder for us today in Jummah. What Allah says? وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. My mercy fitted everything. فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا. I will write it for. Allah will write His mercy to whom? Are you, your name is there or not? Where is the checklist? وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ رَبَّهُمْ. Those the one they fear Allah and they have awareness of Almighty Allah. وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ, and they pay the zakah, the charity, the obligatory. And the one they donate, فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ. And third, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِنَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. And those the one they have iman and faith in all our signs and verses. Number four, الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولِ. Those the one they follow the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. النبي الأمي. Those is the characteristic of those people, Allah will give them the mercy. So you have to obey Allah and obey the Messenger of Almighty Allah in order to achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved brothers, be merciful over the miskeen. Be merciful over the poor person. Be merciful over your children. Be merciful to your wife. Be merciful to your community. Be merciful to your Muslims, brothers and sisters. Be merciful over the people less fortunate than us. Be merciful over the Muslims. They are indulged in war and fight. Be merciful when you buy. Be merciful when you sail. Be merciful when you make any contract with others. Rahim Allah. Look at this hadith. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, Allah have mercy over a person. He is so kind when he sailed, and he is so kind when he buy, and he is so kind when he take a loan. So he is kind in all his deal with others. Allah has had mercy with that person. Rahim Allah, abdan, rajulan samhan. He is so merciful and kind. Idha ba'a wa idha ishtara wa idha iqtada. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to have a mercy over the animals. And you have a lot of ahadith regarding to take care and have mercy over the animals. And I will mention to you one hadith. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ar-Rahimun yarhamuhum ar-Rahman. Those, the one they have mercy over others, Allah will have mercy over them. Irhamu man fil ard. Have mercy over the people in the earth. يَرْحَمُكُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ. Almighty Allah, above the heaven, Allah will have mercy upon you. رواه الإمام أبي داود والترمذي بإسناد حسن وصحيح. جزاكم الله خيرا. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ما يفوز المستغفرين. أستغفر الله. الحمد لله الرحيم الرحمن الحليم العظيم الغفور الكريم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا ونصلي ونسلم على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين. My beloved brothers and sisters, check this character on you, my beloved brothers and sisters, and remember Almighty Allah forgive a woman. She is doing adultery and zina and fornication. Because one time she had a mercy over a dog. When she saw the dog, he was thirsty. She went inside the well and she got a water and she gave the dog a water. And Allah had mercy on her and forgave her. Allahu Akbar, how is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so close to us with the little ibadah, with little things, just have the mercy over the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always, my beloved brothers and sisters, seek forgiveness, make a lot of istighfar, make a lot of dua. Allah says in the Holy Quran, لَوْلَا تَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهِ. Because of your istighfar, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. You might achieve the mercy of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as a believer, my beloved brothers, make a lot of istighfar. Be merciful, make istighfar, make dua. Ya Allah, make me among of those, the one they have a mercy over the creation. So have mercy on me, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Because if Allah give mercy over you, Allah will let you enter Jannah without any problem. Even your deeds is not enough. It's okay. The mercy of Allah will fit over you and all the creation. So have this character of the mercy and always seek the forgiveness from the merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma azza al-islam al-muslimin wa adil al-shirk al-mushrikeen wa dammar a'da'aka a'da'a al-deen. Allahumma raddana al-haq wa al-sirat al-mustaqeem. Allahumma arzuqna sifat al-rahma wa ja'alna min ibadika al-marhumeen. Warhamna ya arhamar rahimeen. Ya Rahman ya Rahim arhamna wa ja'alna marhumeen. Warzuqna sifat al-rahmata على الخلق والمخلوقات أجمعين يا رب العالمين. وارزقنا حسن الأخلاق والأقوال والأفعال يا رب العالمين. أصلح أولادنا وزوجاتنا وأهلينا وذرياتنا إنك على ما تشاء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. الله اللهم إنا نسألك أن تصلي وتسلم على نبينا محمد كما قلت إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا برحمتك وجودك يا رحمن يا رحيم. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا اعتدلوا تراصوا لا تدعوا فرجات للشيطان. الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. ويقولون متى هذا الفتح صادقين. قل يوم الفتح لا ينفع الذين كفروا إيمانهم ولا هم ينظرون فأعرض عنهم وانتظر إنهم منتظرون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
So now, my brothers and sisters, just a quick few announcements. So first one, a few weeks ago, we had talked about a grant writing workshop. So it has been scheduled for next week on Friday and Saturday, the 25th and the 26th of August at Center Care. So it is a workshop to help you get better at writing applications for grants and incorporations. It is being held, as I said, at Center Care in Cranbrook. On Friday, it is from 5:30 till 8 p.m. and on Saturday it is from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. It's free training and the food is provided. We had about 15-20 people sign up, but if you're still interested, please let us know. And if you have signed up, this is your opportunity to attend. Secondly, I just wanted to thank all the volunteers for the success of our event last week. It was one of our biggest events we had with the Eid Fair, alhamdulillah, and we're very grateful for your help and support. If you'd like to become a volunteer and want to help out with future events, please join our Masjid Volunteers group. And on that note, if you'd like to stay up to date with all the updates, we have a Facebook page, a WhatsApp group, Instagram accounts. There are QR codes just outside on the poster. Please join all these groups so you can stay up to date.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My beloved brothers and sisters, inshallah, there are some changes for the Iqama Salah. Salatul Fajr, inshallah, starting from tomorrow, will be 5:30 in the morning, 5:30 Iqama time. And also Salatul Isha, it will be 7:45. So there is 15 minutes earlier for Fajr and 15 minutes delay for the Isha. For the time, please be remind and share this reminder to others, and all welcome to come to Masjid. Jazakumullah khairan.
Thank you.
for the sin.
Yeah.
And this is food because of the Jesus. Because this food, they do
and then what do you do then? Throw that away. But you can't say this, even though itself is a religious
because here and in this his action he will create personal other than religious reason it's become personal reason.
Okay. And I use certified to say whether something is halal or haram. I mean, is this your like your area, like you said, yes, or this is halal, but you certified to, right?
Yes.
Okay, because my next question is if there's teeth they make out of some enzyme that comes from cow sacrifice.
Yes.
So if they don't, like if they don't say, like for example, rennet, that's the stuff they make cheese from, right?
Yes.
So if if they say rendered on a cheese, but it doesn't say whether it's from animal or from plant, because these days they also use chemicals, so then what do we do then? Not consume that product?
Fear Allah as much as you can. Investigate as much as you can. That's how our Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam ordered us, without exaggeration.
Yo, what's up, bro?
Yeah.